Hello students, welcome to the lecture number 1 on the topic Markov chain. In this presentation we will try to learn what is the stochastic process and the Markov chain, and then we will try to learn what is the transition probability matrix. This stochastic process or the Markov chain is one of the most important subject, not in the teaching point of view but also from the research point of view. Many research in these days or from the last 2 decades or 3 decades are continuously growing at their tremendous speed. So as per my experience, my students always suggest me that, sir, this topic is sometime very confusing, it's sometime very easy. So I try to present this concept of Markov chain as well as the probability matrix, try my best to present in the simplest manner. So first of all, where we see in our day-to-day life the Markov chain or the stochastic process. What is the meaning of the stochastic? Stochastic means random. That is, anything is changing with respect to the time. This is called as the random. Anything which are changes with respect to the time. Okay, that is called as the stochastic. So, and the process followed is called as the stochastic process. So everywhere, whenever we are talking about in our day-to-day life, we have seen that stochastic process is surrounding around us. Look at that, the example one that we have seen in our day-to-day life. A very important and very beautiful example for the ladies' point of view. So in a certain market, there are the 3 brands of the lipsticks A, B and C. Everybody knows that there are the several types of the lipsticks available in the markets. So I just considered there are the 3 different types of the brands A, B and C. Now, given that a lady last purchased a lipstick of brand A, so assume that any lady which purchased a brand A type lipstick, so what is the possibility that she will continue with the brand A in the next day or her next visit in the market? What is the probability that, or what is the chances that they can shift to the brand B or C? Okay, so assume that there is a 70% chances that she would continue with the brand A, while 20 and 10% chances that she would shift to the brand B and C. So nobody knows that except for this particular lady that she can shift from the brand A to B or C. Similarly, if a lady last purchased a lipstick B, then what are the chances that she can continue with brand B or switch to the brand A and C? Similarly for this lipstick brand C. Okay, so if we know that the market scenario of the lipstick A, B and C, then my task is to find what is the market share of these 3 brands of the lipstick at the end of the year. So that's my one question that we have usually asked in our day-to-day life. Okay, whenever we are talking about the different types of their brands, products are there. Look at that second example, which are related to the professors. A professor tried not to be late for the class too often. That's the task of us, that we are not trying to be late when the class will start. So, but sometime he or she may be a late, or sometime he is on the time. So if he is late one day, so if in the previous day he is a late, then what is the probability that on the next day he will be on the time? So he is 90% sure that he will be on the time the next time. On the other hand, if he is on the time, then the next time there will be 30% chance he is being on the late. So our task is to find that how often he late for the class. Okay, so what is the meaning is that? So if I call as on the first day he will be the late, what is the probability that on the next day he is also in the late or either on the time B? Okay, similarly on this, if he or she is on the time, what is the probability that he will be late on the next day or on the time? So this is also we have seen in our day-to-day life. Consider one more example is that, suppose that there are the 3 blades which are introduced by the markets in the 3 different companies at the same time, and when they introduce that, the market share of the companies are same. Okay, so if there are the 3, so the market shares will be 1/3, 1/3 and 1/3. And what strategy they have follows that the company A retains the 90% of the customer and lost 3 to the B and 7% to the C. It means if the initial customer uses the company A type blades, then in the next day the company A retains the 90 customers, while the 3 customer uses the brand B razor, and while the 7 use the company C. Similarly for the company B, 70, and then so on. So my task is to find that what are the market shares of these companies at the end of the first years as well as the end of the second years. So such type of the problem. So look at that, all these three examples we have seen in our day-to-day lives are there. So the thing is, where we see the Markov chain, where we see the stochastic process in here. So look at these three cases are there. The most important thing is that the behavior of the change over the time. So that is, we have think in these three cases are what are the behavior. So if you go back to the case number 1, 2, and 3 carefully, so what we'll see that in the case one, what is the behavior is the lady choice to select the brand. So this is the behavior of the lady. Second example, that is the behavior of the professors, whether he or she is on the time or in the late. While in the case third, the behavior of the markets company, that is the three companies over the time. So look at that, in these three cases are there, we have faces over the time. So everything is depending upon the time, on the previous day, on the next day, yesterday, tomorrow. So whenever we are talking about these three behaviors, so the term which we have associated here, we are interested in to know how the random variable changes over the time. So this is the over the time is so crucial. So the thing which are associated with this is called as the stochastic process. So that is, the stochastic process means the anything which are related involving or related a random variable which are changing over the time is called as the stochastic process. So in the probability theory, the Markov model is a stochastic process which are randomly changes over the time. So we have seen the number of the students entered in the classroom before the time t. So when I say that the class started at say 11 o'clock, okay, so if some students enter at 11:05 a.m, some students enter at 11:07 a.m, and so on, how many students are entered at this, can it be constant? Definitely may or may not be there. So I assume that x naught be the number of the students entered in the class at the time t0, xn be the number of the students enter at the time tn. So the stochastic process means that is this are there. So x0, x1, I can represent xn. It is a stochastic process because they are changing over the time. It is not a constant. So they are finite or the countable infinite. So what is the notation? This is the most important thing, is that whenever I just represent that x0 is say my 3, x1 is my 4, and so on. So this means the process, whatever the process. In the previous example, if I called as number of the students, so the process is my student. This is the state. This n representing my time. Okay. What is the notation is? Xn is here. So what is the meaning is, if I called as x3 is equal to 4, so it means I call as here A. So this is the corresponding example 1, that is a lipstick brand A. So the lady will purchase a lipstick brand A after the 3 time period, so after the 3 days. Okay, so here the thing is, what is the state? There is a new thing which I representing here, that is a state. So what is the state here? So I just consider here, in the Markov model, we always focus on the two things. One is the state, second is the transition probability. So how to represent them? I just consider very simple example. Consider the weather. Okay. So whether we are talking about whether the today is a raining day or not a raining day. So that is either rain or no rain. So this is the phenomena. And these two conditions are called as my states. Now the thing is, look at that. These are my states. Now what is the probability? So how you define the probability is, so once a rainy day is there, so what will happen in the next day? Either if it is today, so tomorrow can be rainy or cannot be. Okay, similarly if the present day is not a rainy day, the tomorrow will be rainy or not rainy. So if it is a rainy and it is not rainy, what are the chances that tomorrow is a rainy day? So if I assume that tomorrow is my 40% is that rainy, 60 is a non-rainy, so I can say that rainy today, tomorrow is my 40, rainy to the no rainy, rain to the no rain is my 60. Similarly for here, I assume that this is 70 and the 30. When there is a no rain and tomorrow will be a rain, is a 70 and so on for the 30. So these 60, 70, these are called as my probability sample. So I can represent this model with the matrix are there. So there are the two states, so rain and no rain. Rain and no rain. So what is the probability that rain to the rain is 40 and so on. So you can draw the transition matrix from the diagram and you can draw the diagram from the transition matrix. Now what is the Markov chain? So it is a process of x0, x1, x2 and then so on, and these are the simplest model is there. So what is that? Look at that. So I remember the last slide is there. Go back to the last slide and see that. It means this is my time period. Always remember, xn is my whatever is the right here is a time period. This is my state. Okay. So xt of 5 is means the process in the state 5. What is the time is at a time t. So time means the process after the 5 time period is there. What is the Markov property is that? So if I say the basic property of the Markov chain is whatever the state we have calculated after a time, it depends upon only on the previous one, not on the remaining one. So it means if I say t plus 1 at a time t is nothing but the j. So what is means this is independent of this lines are there. Okay. I just explained it with the numerical example out there. So look at that. One is the meaning is the Markov chain is depend only on the present one but not on the past one. Look at that. Simple example is random walk. A person moving in a zigzag motion are there. After certain time t, so either the person can move in this direction or either can move person in this direction. So the movement in this direction or this direction totally depending upon here. It does not depend upon this, the movement of this previous position. So it means whenever we are talking about the position at t plus 1, it totally depends upon the position at only point the t. It doesn't depend upon the this is the t minus 1, this is t minus 2, and this is my initial position. It is independent of the previous position. One more example is that, so consider that this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are my states. These are my states. Say this is your home. This is your classroom. Okay, say this is my canteen. Okay, this is say building lawn and so on. So my task is to reach at the classroom. You can start from anywhere. So what is the meaning of this is 5. 5 is a state. So I called as this is my parking. I call as a parking. Okay, and this is the G block, any block is there. So what is the meaning is you start from the 5, that is you start from this at the initial time, then go 5 to the 2, then 2 to 4, it means you must go from here, then go from here 5 to 4, and then finally reaching at the point 6. So if you look at this, how many paths are there when you start, when you reach at the point 6, say start from the 5. So how many paths are there? Firstly, path is either you can go from 5 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 3 and 3 to 6. This is the one path. Second path is you can go 5 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6. Other path is you can go 5 to 2, 2 to 2 again because there is a self loop, then 1, then 3, then go again back 3 to 1, then for the 2, then go to 5, then 5 to 6, or you can go directly 5 to 6. But I just want to calculate in this particular example what is the probability that when you start from the 5, reach at the point 6 through this path. So what is the probability that you will be able to reach? Okay, so this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are my states. And the corresponding probabilities are given to be here. So what is the Markov chain said that you want to reach at the point 6. So it depends upon directly on the previous position. So what is the previous is my this, only this. So it means this is independent of this. So this is nothing but is equal to this. So the thing is how to calculate this. So in order to calculate this, we need the probabilities. So I have the probability this. So for it, I can construct the probability matrix. So there are these six. These are my states. So 1 to 1, how many probabilities are there? 0.1. 1 to 2, 1 to 2, that is my 0.5. 1 to 3 is my 1 to 3 is my 0.4. 1 to 4, there is no direct path going from 1 to 4 and 0. So these are my probabilities are there. Now what is the transition probability? This is the most important thing. Okay. So there are the two types of the transitions are there. One is the one step, second is the n step. One step means if you that is a one step means that is a one day or one period. So look at that, you start from the I. How you write that? So look at that, you start from the 2 ending at the 3. So that the meaning is 2 2 3. This is the notation, and this is the time period. What is the difference between them is 1. So that's why this is called as the one step period. So you can write here as 1. 1 means one time period. Look at here, you start from the 0, reach at the point 2. So this is my 0, 2. What is the time period is? 2 minus 1 is 1. While for the n step period, look at that. You start from the 2, ending at the 3. So that is a 2, 3. What is the time period is? Here is a 0, here is the 0, here is the 2. How many period is there? 2. It means you have to take the 2 days to reach at the point here. Similarly for here. So in general, look at the I to J, IJ. What is the difference between the time period is N. Okay. So if you go back to last slide, so look at that. How you write that? You go from 4 to 6. So it means the probability from 4 to 6, what is the time period is? 1. So this is the probability for the one day. So look at 4 to 6. So this is there. So the answer of this is 0.5. So there is a 50% chance that when you follow this path, you will reach at this 0.6. So the corresponding matrix you can formulate is called as the transition matrix. So when this transition matrix is called as the TPM, that is the transition probability matrix. So there are basically three things are there. One, it must be the square matrix, always. Okay, so it always be the square matrix. It can be the 2 cross 2, it can be the 3 cross 3, but it can't be 2 cross 3. It can't, it is not a square. Second is, since the probability is there, so all the values element representing here is called as the must be greater than 0. And the third is the sum of each row is equal to 1. Sum of each row is called as 1. If any matrix follow these three properties, we call as the TPM. So look at the last example again. Check whether this is a TPM or not. First of all, this is a square matrix. Satisfied. Is the sum 1? Yes. The sum will be 1. Each number is greater than or equal to 0. So it means this is my TPM. Transition probability matrix. Now, always remember that whenever you are trying to draw the TPM, this you are trying to draw the TPM, here is my state 1, 2, 3, say 1, 2, 3, always here, that is a row is my past position and this is my present position. Okay, it means if you purchase something in the last day, what will happen in the future? Or you can say this is a now. If you call as this as a now, what is the future of the now is next. Okay, or if you can say that from 1 to 2, from the past day to the next day, so from the past to the next day, from the present to the future. Okay, and how you represent this P22 or PN2 is, so look at that. If I call as PN2, what is means this? Look at N2, so it means you start from the N, ending at the 2, N2. Okay, what is the step size is 1. So it means if I call as x2, then it called as the x1. Okay, or you can write also as n2, because you need a probability size 1, time period 1. If you call as x4, okay, you go from n to 2, then it must be 3. So look at this example, I already explained you that, but is that this is nothing but the 4 to 6 step size 1. So this is the transition probability. So consider the example. So in order to explain this theory, because I understand that this first lecture is basically represented on the theory point of view, so it may quite confusing, but you try to listen this lecture two times, so it will definitely help you. So look at that. What is the meaning of this? A market survey is made on the two brands of the breakfast food A and B. Every time a customer purchases, he or she buy the same brand or switch to the another brand. So it means this is a random process. It means this is the stochastic. And the transition matrix is given to here. So can we call as this as a TPM? So first of all, this is a 2 cross 2 matrix. That's 2. Fine. It's a square matrix. All the elements are greater than or equal to 0. Second condition also satisfied. If the sum is 1? Yes. So it is a TPM. It is a transition probability matrix. But what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this is? What is the meaning is, if the person, if the person purchase brand A, this, in the last visit, okay, so if the person purchase the brand A breakfast in the last visit, then there is a probability that 0.2, that is a 20% is probability that he or she will switch to the brand B in the next visit. Okay, always remember that this is my from to. This is my past behavior. This is my future behavior. Okay, so if this is in the last visit, so what will happen in that next visit? So there is a chances that a person who demanded the breakfast food A, he or she can buy the brand B. There's a 20. Similarly, if somebody wants to buy the brand B in the last visit, there is a 60% chance that he can buy the brand A in the next visit. So consider the next example, that is a Coke versus PepsiCo example. Given that a person last purchase is Coke, there is a 90% chance that the next cola purchase will also be the Coke. And if the person last purchase was Pepsi, 80% chances that the next cola purchase will be again a Pepsi. So you have to construct the TPM. So how many states are there? Since the task is about the Coke and the Pepsi only, so there is a 2 cross 2 size. Okay. So what is this 90% given to you? The last purchase is cola. So this is my last purchase. So the last purchase is Coke. The next purchase will also be the Coke. So the next one, this is the previous, this is the future. So the next purchase is also with a Coke, so the value will be 90. While the last purchase is Pepsi, so this is the Pepsi for the last purchase, 80% chance is that the next cola purchase will also be the Pepsi. So the Pepsi to Pepsi will be 80. Now you have to construct the TPM, so it means you have to find these missing entries. So now since the sum will be 1, so you can easily find their remaining entries. Look at one more example is there. So three boys A, B and C are throwing a ball to each other. A throw ball to the B. B always throw the ball C and so on. So how many states are there? So there are the three states A, B and C. So there is a need to construct this TPM. So look at that. The what is the first condition suggest to? A always throw the ball to the B. What is meaning of that? A always throw to the ball to the B. It means always throw B. It means he never throw to the C and never to the B. So the chances are 0, 1, 0. Similarly, look at the second condition is B always throw to the ball C. So B always throw to the ball C, always. So that is a 1, others are 0 because it's always. What the C is? C is likely to throw the ball as B as of the A. What is the meaning is? They have the same chances. Because C is likely to throw the ball to the B as of the A. So, and how you calculate that this value is, since the sum will be 1, so you calculate the value is half. So now this half and half, so the PPM will be this one. Look at one more example is there. So a company A, there is a 40% market share of the B and C, and the study are here. Okay, so clearly sees that there is a 3x3 matrix corresponding to the company A, B and C. Okay, so this is there. So what is that? Look at that. Company A retains 70% of the customer and gain 5% from the company B, 10% from the company C. Look at very carefully this example. A company A retains, so it means this is a gain. So gain will happen in the future. So it means this is my, if this is my past, this is my future behavior. So the gain will happen to the company A. It means this is the column corresponding. Okay, this is not for the past behavior. This is the behavior corresponding to the future given to that. Because it is given that the company A retains 70% of the customer, so A to A is 70, and gain 5% is from the company B. So A gain from the 5% is from the company B, and 10% is from the C. Okay. Similarly, second says the company B retain 90% is to the B, say 90% is 14 gain from the A. So B gain from the A is 14, and similarly say here. And look at for the C, and clearly say that this is the TPM because the sum will be 1, so this is the TPM. Look at the one more example is there. So some professors are there on the first day of the week, the transition is given to be here. Now you have to construct the TPM. So look at that, how many states are there. So there are the full credit, this is the half credit, and the end. And since it's a TPM, so it always be the square matrix. So what is the F2F? F2F, it's my 30. What is F2H? F2H, this one is my 0.25. F2N is my 0.45. Similarly, you can write here from this diagram. And you can see that the sum will be 1. Okay, so again, I just consider same example, that is the lipstick brands are there. So how to construct the TPM is, since there are the three brands, so there are the A, B, C. So what is the first chances? If the brand A, 70% chances that she would continue with the brand A. So A to A, 70 is there. While 20 and 10% chances that she would shift to the B, 20, and C is as 10. For the brand B, 50% chances that she would shift to the brand A. So B to the, so shift towards to the brand A, this means this will be the future, okay, and this will be the past. So 50 is there, while 10% is to the brand C. So you can find the remaining one, sum will be 1, so you can find it easily. Similarly for the brand C, 60 and 20 for the A and B, while the remaining you can calculate. Similarly, you can see that the professor examples are there. So there are the two states are there. These are always be the state. One is the late and second is on the time. So what will happen if he is late one day? So it means if he is late one day, 90% is he is on the time. So 90% is late on the time, so there is a 90. Similarly, if he is on the time, then the next time he is a 30% will be late. So 30 is there. And the remaining things you can calculate, that the sum will be 1. You can calculate the value will be 0.1 and the 0.7 will be there. So this is the TPM for this professor example. While the next example we have considered, that the razor blades are there. So look at that. In this example, the company A retained 90% of the customer, while this is a lost 3%. So since there is a loss of them, so I consider this as a loss, this as a gain. So it means this is a loss, so that means we are talking about the row wise. In the last example, there is a gain, so we are talking about this gain. So A retain 90%, so A retain 90, while loss to the 3%, so 3 is there, and 7% to the company C. Similarly, 70% for the B, and so on. So you can construct this as a TPM. So this lecture is basically talking about the TPM, how to construct the TPM, because whenever we are trying to find the probabilities of certain state, if I call as this, for example here, I call as find the probability that this of say 2 is equal to A. What is the meaning of that? What is the meaning is, what find the probability that a person purchased the blade B when his last visit purchased the product A. So how you write that? This is nothing but A to B. What is the step length is 2 minus 3, that is a 1. So that is a 1. So this is P raised power 1. This nothing is 1. So A to B, what is the answer is A to B is 0.03. But if somebody called that, if this is my B and X0 is my A, what is the meaning is that? Initially he purchased the product A after how many time period is? 3. So how you write it as from A to B, what is the time period is 3. So what is the meaning is, a person who initially purchased A, later on he purchased B, but calculate the probability after the third visit. It means after he or she visited 3 times in the market, what is the probability that, since this is the value of the P, so it this is not be equal to 0.03 cube. This is not be there because this is not the cube. So till then you can simply practice the TPM. Wait for the next lecture. We will try to learn how to find the probability in one of the simplest manners there.